So, in this video we will see how the Fedora administrator will be able to set up SMS packages inside the accounts panel. We will also see how he can create multiple SMS packages and assign them to different schools or multi-school groups. Log in into my accounts.fedora.com panel. So this is the place where you create the school. So here you will see the schools that you've created. So I have created two schools in this panel and one multi-school group. Now let's go to company and see what is SMS package management. So here you will see this option of SMS. And here you will see the UI is changed. Earlier, you could do SMS settings in this screen. So you will get username, you will get password, host URL, and other fields to be filled in directly. But now you can create SMS packages. To create an SMS package, click on this option, which is Create SMS Package. Now here, you can set up the name of the package, the provider name, message limit, the validity of this package, and the character limit, which is by default 160 characters and can be overwritten as per the service provider. Now let's understand this by an existing SMS package that I've set. So I've created SMS package as the name of the package, and I've filled in the SMS provider details. The message limit, 600 messages are allowed till 31st of August 2017. So this is the validity which you can select from here. Character limit is default 160. And then you will see parameter mappings. So here, earlier we used to have username and the value against that username. But now we have combined the parameter and the username. So you will see against username, I have written user ID. And against user ID, I have written the value of that user ID. So this is how we'll be creating the parameters. So here, similarly for password, I have written the password. And then what is the actual value against that password? And then the sender name. So all the schools or the multi-school groups inside this company will follow the sender name that you mentioned here. It means when the students or the parents or the employees receive SMS, it will be from this name, NetSMS in my case. Now, if you want to allow the schools or the multi-school group to be able to change this sender name, then you can select this option, which is sender name modification enable. So now that means that the school will be able to give their own sender name instead of NetSMS. Similarly, multi-school group will be able to assign their own sender name for their schools. Then we have host URL. This is similar to what we had earlier. The success code, the message, and the phone number. So these are the parameters, the last two that you see. Success code, the value against the success code, host URL, as per what is provided to you by the SMS provider in the API documentation. So like this, I have added SMS package as the package name. You can add multiple SMS packages now. Earlier, we could only have one SMS package and we could assign it to the schools by inheriting the SMS settings. Now we can have more than one SMS packages, so you can create another SMS package here. So you will see I've already created two SMS packages. SMS package, the first one, new SMS package, the second one. You can see the SMS limit is 600. The validity is what we've set when we created this SMS package. Available SMS is currently 600. Now we can assign the SMS package to the schools. So earlier, when you used to create a new school, you used to get an option here, inherit SMS settings. And the school, if you check that, the school would be able to use the same SMS settings. But now, since we can create more than one SMS package, we can assign the schools from here itself. So you will see this option of schools coming against this package name. When I click on it, you can check these SMS package details and then assign a school or a multi-school group which will be using this SMS package. So currently you can see I have not assigned any school or multi-school group to use this SMS packages. I have created two schools here by the name PRG and Arun, and one multi-school group by the name ABC. Now let's assign the SMS package to the schools and the multi-school group. So here we'll go to company, SMS, and click on schools in front of the SMS package that you want to assign to the schools or multi-school group. Click on add a multi-school group or school. It means assigning an existing group or a school. Now here you can select what kind of school you want to assign. Is it a normal school or is it a multi-school group? If I select school, I will get the two schools that I have created, which was PRG and Arun. So let's assign this package to PRG school. So here it shows me available SMS, which is the total SMS of the package, which was 600. I can assign a lesser number of messages for this school, PRG, and also give a validity, which should be before the validity or on the same day of the validity of the package. So let me give the validity like this. So I can assign a package to PRG school, the same SMS package, but not the full assignment. I have taken 100 messages to be used by PRG school. So now you will see multi-school group or school which is assigned. In this case, the school PRG, it shows the validity, allotted SMS 100, and available SMS is 100 since we have not used them. This count will decrease when the school starts using the SMS. Now if you see here, available SMS reduced to 500 from 600 in this package. Now let's assign the same package to another school. Let's say we have Arun school and we want to assign 200 messages to this school. And we can also set the validity the same way we had done for PRG school. So you can see it gets added to the list of schools that are assigned to use this SMS package that we earlier created. And the SMS, available SMS, is now reduced to 300. Now let's assign multi-school group. So here I'll select the type to be multi-school group, and I'll get that ABC group that I've already created. I'll give the message limit. So let's use all the messages. Available is 300, and I'm mentioning 300 here, and I can set the validity as well. So now if you see for this SMS package, there are three kinds of schools who are going to use it. ABC, which is a school, PRG, which is a school, sorry, ABC, a multi-school group, and PRG and Arun, which are schools. At any point, you can remove the schools or multi-school group from using this SMS package by going to their settings and clicking on Remove SMS Packet. Also, you will see this option of the status, which is active or inactive. So in front of the school, you will see active option or inactive option. You can activate the SMS package for this school by making it active from the status. So like this, we can assign an SMS package that we've created to multiple schools and multi-school groups, and we can activate them or deactivate them at any stage. Now, as I said, in the company, in the SMS settings, we can have more than one SMS package. So here you will see I've created one more, which is new SMS package. Now here I can assign schools to this SMS package also. So let's assign a school. We'll select PRG as a school to be assigned. And for this SMS package, the available SMS was 900. Let's say the school will be using 200 and we'll set some validity. So here you can see that PRG will be using new SMS package as well as the other SMS package, but at a time only one will be active. So you will see by default the new one becomes inactive. So if you want to activate this SMS package for PRG, the other one will by default become deactivated. So if we see this SMS package PRG status, it will be inactive because we have activated the other SMS package. So that means you can assign more than one SMS package to the schools, but at a time, only one will be active for the school.